Here's a segment from a recent Gun Talk Radio episode. You can listen to all the Gun Talk Radio podcast however you tune in, or check out guntalk.com for more.
I got to go talk about this. This sounds very interesting. Scott called in from Shreveport. Scott, you're talking about electronic guns. What are we talking about here?
Well, not electronic guns. It's a gentleman last week brought up an electronic electromagnetic pulse and being able to get in his safe. And I have been meaning to call you about this. EMP devices are available handheld. You can build them. There's electronics online where you can put them together and build them out of common parts. And those would render fingerprint guns useless if one were used around them.
Let me see if I understand this. When you say an EMP device, you would actually have a device that would send out a low-powered electromagnetic pulse that could deactivate an electronic device around you.
Correct.
Huh.
And they're available to be built on the internet. And there's a couple scenarios with that. Think of a bank. A bad guy builds one of these things, and he walks in a bank, hits the button, all the guards' guns are useless. Another scenario, and this is just way out there, anytime a lot of people that law enforcement does not like, say, not riots, but protests or anything like that, they could activate that device locally and take out everybody's gun.
And radios and...
Yeah, and radio, what we're talking about is, you know,
anything else out there.
For those who are not following, let me just fill in. We're talking about one of the technologies that the gun ban people really like to push is the idea of electronic lockout devices where only you would be able to use your gun, fingerprint readers, that type of thing. And so what you're saying is that a device like this would render it inoperable. Not to mention the fact that darn things are not reliable anyway. No thinking person would trust one of these for his or her life. But that's I had not thought of that, and I didn't know about. You know, I know that you can get cell phone jammers, but I didn't know you could get little EMP things.
Yeah, you can. The other thing I would think would really come to forefront in my mind would be you have an electronic safe, can't get into it.
If you got, you know, I don't have electronics on my safe. Mm-hmm. I have the old-fashioned dial tumbler thingy.
Me too.
You know, and as a part of my security system, I write the combination on the outside of the door.
Sharpie, yeah.
Exactly. So, you know, but I write it backwards so no one would be able to actually
figure that out.
Yeah, I thought that was pretty good code there. There you go. Hey, Scott, thank you for that call. I appreciate that. That's never thought about EMPs that way.
Mm-hmm.